We'll see you soon, here on 368.
In PowerDirector 16, how about we teach you in a tutorial the Casey Neistat flicker effect. Let's get to this.
Alrighty then, let's teach you how to do the Casey Neistat flicker effect in PowerDirector 16. This is a very easy effect, and you're actually going to use your camera to manipulate a little bit of this. Now, you're going to record your spill, which is sitting in your chair, and whatever you're saying. Get out of your chair, and then actually record probably a good 10 or 15 seconds with nobody in the chair at all. And that particular video, you're actually going to put in the top. I've done mine a bit different with a green screen, but you'll get the gist of it when I'm showing you what to do here. In your case, record, like I said, I don't know, 10, 15, 20 seconds with nobody sitting in a chair and just pointing at whatever wall you're pointing at. Put that in the top line where I've got this picture. And then the other line where you're doing your spill is where we're going to start to edit and add this so-called flicker effect. Now, this is too tight for us to see anything. So we want to expand this way out is what we want to do. And I really want to really grab this bar and just really pull it out as far as I can, okay? This is going to allow me to go frame by frame, and that's what I want. Now, I've already put a line where I want to start here. And what we're going to do is we're going to click this arrow here. It's right beside this one with the seek by. This one says next frame. So I'm going to hit this 1, 2. So I went 2 frames. I'm going to make sure this is highlighted in blue, and then I'm going to cut that frame right there. And I'm just going to repeat this process, 1, 2, over and over. And you can play with this basically as many times as you want until you get the hang of it. Now, originally, I did upload this video with doing it as 1 frame, and it just flew through it too quick when I had uploaded it to YouTube, as if YouTube's algorithm or the processing had done something to it. 2 frames seems to be pretty good. You're going to have to judge how many you actually want to do and how you actually want to do the actual effect. So once you do this over and over and over, and I would suggest you make a small video to get the hang of this, upload it to YouTube, look at it, and see if it's what you want. Make whatever adjustments, delete it, upload another one, and just kind of get the hang of how you want the look to work. Because I could have took this even a step further, and I could have went into like my transition room and even added a transition to these. So, you know, here I am at the end. I've got enough there all cut up. I'm going to take this tail end of it, and I'm just going to remove it. Poof, all gone. Now, this is where the effect takes its course, okay? Every other one, I'm going to highlight that in blue and hit my delete key, we want to remove. So I want to leave the gap, okay? Remove, leave gap. So that way I have that gap there. I want that one. I want to remove that one. So I'm removing every other one, if you can see there. That's what I'm doing. So now I've got this space in between, and each one of these are 2 frames. Add some flicker effect, basically, whatever sound you want. I'm going to cut the end of that off. And there you go. And I'm going to go back here. And basically, we're literally going to do the same thing. I'm going to move ahead 2 frames, 1, 2. And I'm just going to cut these off as I go. And I'm doing each one as 2 frames. So the process really is just the same thing as what we just did. Now, I probably have too many, and I've added too many on purpose, so you can actually see it working. I probably could have added a little less, but I really wanted to give it the, to really show you the complete effect while it's working. And you notice I'm just sitting here and you're working in the same spot over and over. And we're working in the way of two frames. You could try three frames or four frames or even break it up. Try one with two, one with one, you know, and see how yours actually comes out. And the same thing applies. Wherever the space is, we're simply going to remove and leave the gap is all we're going to do. Make sure it's highlighted in blue before you get delete happy. Okay, so there we go. We got an end. So let's give this a play, and let's see how it looks.
In PowerDirector 16, how about we teach you in a tutorial the KC9-Stat flicker effect. Let's get it.
And you'll notice in PowerDirector, it's actually looking like it's too slow, is what it's looking like while I'm editing it in PowerDirector. And here's what I was talking about. When you actually upload it to YouTube, it actually gets a whole lot faster. So what you're seeing when you're editing truly is not in live time compared to when you put it on YouTube. And that's why I'm kind of saying, like, create one, put it on YouTube, then look at it, leave it in private, and then look at it and get the hang of it and see how it looks. So there's how you do the KC9-Stat flicker effect. Really easy. Just work on this section here. At any rate, guys, give me a thumbs up, and hey, I'll catch you on the next one.
We'll see you soon, here on 368.
In PowerDirector 16, how about we teach you in a tutorial the KC9-Stat flicker effect. Let's get to this.